Hello and welcome to SustainablePrepping.com, your home for fear-free emergency preparedness on the internet. I'm Brecky, and today I am taking you on a mini haul. I'm going to show you a grocery haul that I got today that was a mini stock-up haul. Several of you have asked me about what I actually get when I go grocery shopping. What do I actually stock? How do I purchase for a preparedness pantry? So I want to show you what I got today. Now here's some full disclosure. This is not fancy. I am not a fancy vlogger. I don't have a tripod. My kids are playing outside. My house is a mess. And I don't have all the fancy lighting, as you can see. So just bear with me because this is sort of my first vlog style video. Let me show you what I got. Okay, so this is basically the haul. It's not huge, but it is a nice little pickup and it's going to cover some different bases that we needed. So the first couple of things up here I'm going to show you are lids for regular mouth sized mason jars. We have a ton of these and I have lost all of my regular sized plastic lids. These are great for everyday use, but these are also great if you need to put freeze dried stuff away. So then I have these, they are meal prep containers. They are plastic, which is not my ideal, but it didn't have glass that was in our price range for right now. So we are doing more weekly meal prep. And you might think, why on earth is this in an emergency preparedness video? But here's the thing, learning to meal plan and meal prep as a skill is absolutely a part of having a good emergency preparedness plan because it means you know how to use things up and use leftovers and eat what you have. So we were running out of stuff like this, so I bought a new pack. The same thing really goes for here. These are kind of multi-purpose lasagna kind of pans. They are aluminum and they can go in the freezer. And so I plan on doing some freezer cooking here. We have a big old chest freezer right there with all the art, as you can see. And so we're gonna, we've been eating away at a half a cow that we purchased almost a year ago. I guess we got it in November. So we are gonna start refilling it with some freezer meals. And I also got some recycled aluminum foil so I can feel a little bit better, right, because it's recycled, as well as some Ziploc bags. Again, these are all so that I can start making some freezer meals, have some meals in my freezer. Y'all that have been around know that I teach a three-part pantry, and that three-part pantry includes your fridge and your freezer. That's your first tier. Now, in a video I just recorded, I was talking about how Apple products are hard to find. We have been fighting to get applesauce where I'm at. So I got three jars of applesauce. They only had like five jars, so I didn't want to take all of them. So I got three jars of applesauce, and then I got four bottles of organic apple juice. We do prefer to have all of our apple products organic, but there was like no options for organic applesauce. So, you know, you win some, you lose some. But we have four bottles of apple juice. Now here's the thing, here's a note, okay? We keep juice around, not just because we have kids. We don't let them drink juice straight. We always mix it with water. But juice offers both a easy to swallow, like electrolyte kind of balance because there's sugars in here. It's a you can use it for rehydration if you need to. But this also has a little bit of fiber in it, not a lot. But if you have little ones that get a little plugged up, apple juice, pear juice, prune juice, obviously. Having a little bit of this on hand can be a natural laxative for little kids, well, for adults too, but especially for little ones. So now we have four bottles. I like to keep at least four bottles on my shelf. We were down to only one because we've had a hard time finding it. So I stocked up. Okay, I got a little pack of toilet paper. I try to buy a little toilet paper, not every single week, but gosh, pretty regularly. I didn't want to buy a giant pack because we bought some 2 weeks ago that we won't be opening it for months, but I want to get a little bit. And our downstairs, we live in a really old house. Our house is almost 100 years old, so our downstairs bathroom needs the real thin toilet paper. So this is for our downstairs to have an extra backup supply. We also have over here some Lysol laundry sanitizer. We don't need this right now because we have a bottle, but this is a backup. When you have little kids, you know, potty training, all that stuff, you want to be able to keep your laundry clean. So we have some backup there. Moving on over here, I just want to point this out. I got another thing of Gatorade powder. Again, this is a rehydration tool. Yes, you can get special rehydration salts, and look, y'all can make your own rehydration powders, but this for me, as a mom of four who works a full-time job, has this as a side hustle, right? This is so much easier. I'm saving time by spending a little extra money. Yeah, there's a lot of sweetener in this, but we don't drink it every day. And as a rehydration powder, it lasts a long time as long as it stays sealed. It's, for me, it's worth having on hand. We were down to only one unopened canister. I'd like to have at least two unopened canisters plus whatever we have open. So now we're back to that. I got some more of these little family instant mashed potatoes. I know, real mashed potatoes are 1,000% better, I agree. However, these are $1 a piece and they're a great side if you want to eat them regularly. However, you can add these to your emergency pantry. They have a minimum of a 1 year, I think they have more like a 2 year shelf life. Yeah, these are good until March of 2022, and they probably would be fine for several months after that. And they give you an easy, cheap carb. And if you get the ones with the butter, the cheese, there's sour cream and chive, there's all kinds of different flavors. They are flavored, so you don't have to worry about trying to buy powdered butter, powdered dairy products. So for a beginner, for someone prepping in a really small place, for somebody who's trying to build on a budget their emergency pantry, these are fantastic. So don't be too good for instant mashed potatoes, y'all. All right, I got some tea votives, little tea lights. They were on a really good sale. There's 100 of them. We have a little lamp that has a mirror, so it makes it larger. Tea lights are great. We had a mouse a while back that ate through some of our candles, so I'm slowly replenishing that stock. Trash bags, this will go in our emergency supplies. Why? Because you don't want to get caught without regular trash bags, and I did. Had to go into my emergency supply to get trash bags. So I've restocked. I'll probably buy another box just to be on the safe side, but that's for today. And then these. These are big, you know, 1.3 mil. I actually like to even have them up to a 3 mil. These are not as thick as I actually want, but they're a good stopgap. These are more like a contractor's bag, and you want these for when you're creating an emergency potty, okay? You can imagine. You don't want your human stuff leaking out, so these are for my emergency potty. I will do a whole video on how to put together an emergency potty later on. This was actually a second mop cover that I got. It's not actually part of my emergency supply kit, but there it is. You saw one of the things I got. And then vinegar. And we do a lot of cleaning with vinegar. You can pickle with vinegar. If you're gonna cook with vinegar, you want store-bought, you don't want homemade because this has a certain level of acidity. But for us, vinegar is something that we do a lot of cleaning with, cleaning the bathroom and clogging toilets. Again, we live in a really old house, so we have to be careful. So that's what we got. This is our big old haul of what we have. So there it is, y'all. This is a mini haul. Now, this is not a dedicated, I went out and I shopped and I made a list and I inventoried, right? This is stuff that I knew that I needed to go and grab. I was at the grocery, I went to Walmart, which I haven't gone into a Walmart in almost 2 years, but I went and I picked all of this up to show you how you can add on to a regular grocery run. I was picking up some dairy, I was picking up some fruit, things like that that we needed to get through this next week, and I was able to add to it. It can be that easy. You can just buy, you know, 1 month, you can buy an extra pack of toilet paper every week, and now you have a supply, right? You know, you can slowly stock up, you can add to your regular grocery hauls. It doesn't have to be comprehensive every single time. So this is a real life sort of mini grocery pickup that is all designed for my emergency pantry. This is all designed for my sort of short-term and mid-term pantry. None of this is long-term stuff. It's stuff that's gonna get used and rotated within the next year. If you have any questions, definitely leave them down below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel if you want more fear-free emergency preparedness content. Until next time, happy prepping.